Well, Tony, say hi to YouTube again.
Huh?
Say hi to YouTube again.
Hi.
What madness made you completely tear up the railroad and start over again?
Last time you and your dad were here, we were running through the aisles, bumping into each other. The train was going from the back room under and through to this aisle, going around back to this aisle, and it was just mass confusion and wasn't really what I was looking for as far as operation.
So this
from
this,
January 15 of this year till the end of May of 15, this is the progress I've made in redoing the layout. A lot more work to do.
So this room got a complete redone. And then the room back here is somewhat intact where the helix was, and looks like you got a little bit of a...
Yeah, I had to go with two duck unders and a removable bridge, two removable bridges to get the long mainline run, incorporating with a couple of nice towns and industry.
What was the dimensions of the main room here?
This room right now I'm occupying 16 by 12.
And in the little room with the helix?
10 by 12.
All right, we'll go run some trains.
Yeah, and I wanted to make the upper level back so it didn't distract.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's no good when it comes out of the last
year. Yeah,
you
know, yeah.
You know, the top one.
It's all for the run.
Nice to see the helix fully operational. Oh, there it goes.
Did it come off the
deck? No, but it stalled. But I made it through because I don't want to walk back there. I made it tough.
Did it move?
Yeah, it's gone.
Nobody goes behind there. I don't use it except for train storage. Pretty much like you got, you know.
Yeah. Well, eventually I want to get a skirt.
You know, well, what I did is I used one of the curtains that were in the
yeah.
room.
Yeah.
And I went to blinds and I just hung the curtains on there. Make them work.
That's
it. They came with the house, so I figured it was time to go to something else. Although the curtains did make it darker in there so that you could actually see the little buildings a little better.
Yeah,
at night, it's actually pretty cool. Especially the depot.
Oh, yeah.
You fill up your alcohol in there.
Yeah, maybe I'll do this. I'll back out of it. I think it might have gone over a switch and derailed a frog or something.
This junction is known as coffee.
What?
This junction is known as coffee, right?
Yeah, coffee.
This is known as the Royal Gorge.
Willamette River.
There you go.
Oh, that's how I got under lights I can put on.
You need more light?
No, this is good. The notorious duck under. Getting from here to there.
It's odd because it always seems to be the last two cars on the...
So this is a great example of a tool. You can see there's some additional cork here where a curve got reran. And this is fast tracks. This is a 24 inch radius. I'm not going to push it all the way in, but you guys get the idea. Come in there and you can draw and measure and glue and do all the good stuff and have true curve radius of what you're trying to get. It looks like from what Tony was saying, they come in 2-inch increments, so you get them different sizes. Then there's the part number. Well, something to consider when building your railroad. Good track cleaning makes for a good layout session. This is one of the brass ones that are out there. I don't remember the manufacturer. Oh, CMX, there it is. I know they're about $125 or so. You can open this up, put whatever kind of fluid you want in there. Run this along with an engine or engine a couple of cars, and the pad will clean the track for you. You can run on a lathe a few times and just come back and clean up a couple of things after that. But the operating session goes a lot better with clean track.